Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today I will give you other experience of my public speaking in a more conservative societies, not like the Islamic societies in the UK. At the beginning of this century, maybe in 2003-2004, I can't remember exactly what year was it, I was invited to give a talk to a Salafi group in Qatar, in Doha. The Sheikh was my best friend, originally from Egypt, and he told me that he is preparing a talk to the women in his group to tell them how to do humanitarian work and social work and all these sort of things. I was thrilled because all of the women are not engaged or not being a part of the process of social change, unfortunately. I was very happy and preparing myself for a big challenge, questions, answer, and all these sort of things. Preparing my speech into phases, beginning, difficulties, achievement, direction, all this. I went to a hall which could take between 500 to 1,000 people in Doha. You know, that's the hall in this country is very big, and the stage is maybe quite far from the first line of seats, maybe about 10-15 meters. I found on the stage it's not like a tent, it's like a blanket or like something to surround us. Me and him sitting on a table, facing one another, and we are surrounded by black curtain to prevent us from looking at someone who might be sitting, and the distance between us and them could be 10, 20, 30 or 40 meters. It depends where the woman would be sitting down. By the time I was starting or sitting next to him, all my thoughts, ideas and experience gone, unfortunately. Because I did not understand how to interact with people behind the curtain at that time. So I struggled very hard to deliver this talk. I couldn't be able to comprehend it. Needless to say that nowadays, because we are in COVID or because of the new technology, that we give talks behind cameras, we give talks on Zoom and all these sorts of things. But we are prepared to give talks to those people, but not in a lecture theater, not when people are sitting and want to listen to you and so on. It was so much difficult to interact at that time with those people. The second one is what happened. I remember the story what happened to, I think, Sheikh Qaradawi or Sheikh Al-Ghazali, when he was invited to speak to the girls in one of the universities in the Gulf again, and they said, no, it's behind, you talk to me, I'm a presenter, it's you don't actually communicate with the sister there. He refused. I think the Sheikh has refused to do that, because this was not the era, it was not the philosophy or the reality of the time. Okay, and my second interaction on this side from the conservative people, we were another place in UK, this time in UK, and the speaker came to speak to also the sisters or the woman, and he was in a hall and they are in another hall, there's no camera, there's nothing actually, and there was a microphone. There is actually, he was talking for nearly 40 minutes, 50 minutes or nearly an hour. And he received a message from one of the participants telling him, Sheikh, sorry, we're not in the room while we are actually talking and delivering your lecture. Can you repeat your lecture again? Because we're actually seeing one of our sisters. She's traveling and leaving the country. So we're with us. Please do repeat the lecture again. This kind of extreme conservatism, we can be conservative, but not to the extreme that we do not interact with the audience. And the people, the Prophet used to go to the mosque and lecture and give khutbah and first group were actually in the mosque facing him were the men, then followed by the young boys, and the followed by the young girl, then the woman at the back. So women were seeing the Prophet was seeing the woman. Where do we get this culture of the blanket and the tent around the woman at that time? Even the Sahaba and later on the Khulafa and all these sort of things. The da'iyah, when he goes to this area, goes with an intention to make da'wah and make the places roomy. And I remember that in most of the places I go, where a lot of sisters, they don't like to sit in the front seats. Most of them always sit at the back seats, naturally. So be conservative, but extreme conservatism is not good for the da'wah, or for education, or for whatever, or communication. Jazakumullah khair, wa assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.